it gives them two important things, access and information. And it does so consistently, and it enshrines in the Constitution the right of victims to get information about their cases, as well as at certain points and under the appropriate guidance of our judges, the opportunity to participate. And that's critically important. And it's important to give victims a voice. And I think without Marcy's law, it all too frequently that did not happen. As a lawyer, you often hear about instances in the judicial system where a victim of a crime did not have the opportunity to be heard. Obviously, criminal defendants have certain rights in the Constitution. They appropriately so. They should be protected. We do believe in innocent until proven guilty, and we believe that those who are accused of a crime should have a fair trial, but that's not mutually exclusive with a victim having the opportunity to be heard and having an opportunity as appropriate to participate. So when I was serving on the Constitution Revision Commission, I heard a lot more about the issue, and I heard a lot of specific instances where victims did not have that right, or these rights were being applied very, very inconsistently. Frankly, working with Marcy's Law got me very passionate about the issue. There's a great dedicated team at Marcy's Law working on these issues around the country, and I was just proud to be a part of it. I think we need to do what we can to ensure that the constitutional rights that are for victims that are now laid out in our Constitution are applied uniformly from jurisdiction to jurisdiction within the state. If there are, if law enforcement needs guidance, if the legislature wants to provide some clarity where there's some arguments about how to apply Marcy's Law, they should do that. I think uniformity is the key. It's fair for our law enforcement. It's fair for the judges that have to apply the law. It's certainly important for victims. Although the big win was getting Marcy's Law in the Constitution, and that is now the law of Florida. But to the extent there's some interpretative differences, I think that if our legislature can provide some guidance, that would be very, very helpful.